Right on. SOSL topic. SOSL stands for Salesforce Object Search Language. SOSL stands for Salesforce Object Search Language. Next, it is used to perform text-based search. It is used to perform text-based search. Used to perform text-based search on all of the records in your database. On all of the records in your database, irrespective of the object. Irrespective of the object. Yeah, you all ki jage all slash multiple kar lo. Like write down all slash multiple instead of all. Multiple objects. So in SOQL, what happens is you write down. No. There's a database, right? And there is your Apex program. So to get the information out from your, or to get the records out from your database, one thing that we write down is SOQL. But SOQL is basically performed onto a particular object only. You cannot perform SOQL, a single SOQL query, onto two objects, right? And in SOQL, you do the searching for records, or you query the records. But when it comes to SOSL, it also sends the records to the Apex program. But what happens is it performs a text-based search. Like let's say I want to search where is Anisha written, right? So, I mean, it might be an account object, it might be in contact object, it might be in a student object. If Anisha name is there in any of the fields of any of the objects, then in that case, that record will be returned as a result of SOSL query. That's exactly what SOSL query is, and this is how it is different from SOQL. So if you want to perform a text-based search, irrespective of the objects, irrespective of the fields, then in that case, you're going to write down SOSL. In SOQL query, if I ask you that, please give me the records in which the name starts with Anisha. Then what is the query that you're going to write down? Select name from whatever object account where name like Anisha, name like Anisha percentage. That's exactly what you're going to do. But that will only compare Anisha with a name field on that account object, not with other objects. And what if the name is not mentioned in that particular field? It is mentioned in some other field. So we'll have to write down that as well. So instead of, if we do not know on which object that data might be, or on which field that data might be, then in that case, we'll perform SOSL query instead of SOQL. Is that clear? Cool. So like there is SOQL and there is SOSL. When you're going to use SOQL? And you have to search from. Okay, so when you're sure that what data you want and from which object you want and what exactly you want to compare in the condition, but when you're not sure about it and you want to do text-based searching, what are you going to use? SSL. That's what it is, right? So let's start with this. I will look in Apex, right? In query editor, it's the same. So similar to SOQL, in SOQL the keyword is select, right? But in SOSL, it's fine, right? And then what? What basically means what do you want to search? That's what you have to write down in here, right? And then comes in. Find what? What is basically what do you want to search? What text you want to search? In basically means that in which fields you want to search it. And then you have to specify the type of fields in which you want to search it, like email or something like that. And then comes returning. Returning basically describes that, in which objects you want to search it. Though it can be searched on multiple objects or all the objects. But if you want, you can define, I want to search it on account, contact and student only, not on any other object. So you can specify it after returning. I mean, don't worry. We're going to discuss it one by one later in this program. So there is one example. Find John. The difference between Apex and Query Editor is, by the way, SOSL can be executed in Query Editor as well. Right? Okay, so if I want to search John, I'll write down find John in Query Editor like this. And if it would have been Apex, then I would have written it down like this. Got it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's go to Query Editor and just execute the SOSL query. Find John. And now in account, there are five John, or there are five records in which John is coming up. In student, there is one record in which John is coming up. In contact, there are two records in which John is coming up. Oh, sorry, this is Apex class. In this Apex class, there are five Apex class in which John is there. In account, there is only one John. In lead, there are three John. And in opportunity, John is coming for seven records. So all the records which include John in any of the field, in any of the object, are getting returned to me, right? Like, I'm able to access it over here. So this is what SOSL can do. Is it clear? Okay. Now let's talk about the further things about it. Where? Right? So in which object you want to search it? That's what we want to talk about. So I want to search it only on account and only on contact. So we do not need list of S object to fetch the values. Currently we are talking about query editor. We are going to talk about list of S object or list of S object or whatever it is when we are going to write it down in Apex. So you got to wait for that. Okay. So the next thing is where clause. In where clause, what happens is like, okay, see, find John, right? So we want to search John, but we want to search it only in account and contact object. So we're going to use returning keyword, and after that we'll specify the objects in which I want to search it, separating them by a comma. Is it clear? Okay. So I'll just write it down in the query editor like this. Currently there is Apex class, student, contact, account, lead, everything is coming up. I just want to write down returning account, comma, contact. It will return me only two objects. Or it will search this text only in two objects, account and contact. If you want to add more. That's how it goes. Make sense? Okay. Make sure to write it down, right? Then comes what type. What type basically describes the search group. With the help of what type, you can describe or you can point out in which data type fields will be able to search it, right? So there are multiple options. Name fields, it will only search the record in the name fields. Email fields, it will only search the text in the name fields, and this will only search the text in email fields. This will only search the text in phone fields. That's what it is. And by default, it is all fields. Default. Right? This all fields is default. By default, it searches in all the fields. And if you want to only search it in name fields, then you can search it. You can specify in name fields. If you only want to search it in email, then just write down email. So let's do that over here. I'm going to specify account, comma, contact. So there are there is one record that is coming up from account and two from contact. Now let me write down in name fields. Again, the same thing, but if I'm going to change it to email fields, there's only one contact in which John is there. Is it clear to all of you? Right? And if I'm going to write down in phone fields, There's only account that is coming up in which there is John and phone, right? So that's what it is. And by default, it is all fields. So no matter whether you write it down or not, it's one and the same thing. In fold fields, you can add text. Let's search that as well. Uh, 0016 QSE. Accounts. If I'm going to create a new account, where is the phone field? Got it? Okay. So that's what the power of search group is. And then search group basically defines in which fields you want to search it. And with the help of returning, you define object, in which objects you want to search it. That's it. Okay. You basically mean two search groups, email fields and phone fields, something like that. No, that's not two fields. That's two search groups. Because we cannot specify the field in which you want to search. That's what it is. Okay. Now, currently, see, if I'll execute this, it is only returning ID, right? I want more fields. How can I get that? What should I do? Damon John, number of employees, 0. Bond test, Bond John at Grand Hotel, and it's Doi, John Doi. Getting it? If you want more fields to be returned as a result of SOSL, you're just going to use parentheses after the object name and then you're going to write down the fields that you want. Use this one. Write down this one. Come on. Done. So till now we have executed this in query editor. Now let's go back and see how we'll write it down in SSL query or Apex. Right. So the number one thing is, whenever you want to write down SOQL or SOSL, there is no database connection that you have to create. All what you have to do is write that query inside the square brackets. Right. That's the same thing that I've done over here. Find Volkswagen, right? So instead of using curly braces in here, I've used single quotes because that defines the string. But this will not work in Apex. See, the above statement will give an error. SOSL in Apex needs to have the entities or objects specified. That means you always have to specify returning in here while writing down the SOSL query. That's all what it is, right? So you can just write it down. And then we'll talk about what is the return type of SOSL query. Done? Okay. Now let's talk about what is the return type of SOSL query, right? So over here, I'll just search find John and execute it. Tell me what is coming up. These are not IDs, these are S objects, right? Account, this is account S object, this is lead S object. There are three lead S objects, right? There are 7 opportunity S objects. There are 2 contact S objects. So don't you think that it is coming up in this format where this is a reference which refers to another list This one stores the reference to the list which has got Apex classes. This one. What? This one. Lead in this one opportunity. So like this Apex classes is nothing but a list of list which includes single Apex classes which contains John. Student, again, this student is a list where all the student records which meet this particular criteria, which has got this particular text, are there. And this is for contacts, this is for accounts, this is for leads, and this is for opportunities. So this single is a list of S object. Yes or no? This single is a list of S object. So basically we can call it as list of opportunity. This is list of lead. But the parent of all of these S object is S object class. So this is nothing but a list of S object, list of S object, list of S object, list of S object, list of S object. And when you want to store references of so many list of S object, what are you going to do? You're going to create a two-dimensional list, right? In which this will store the reference to another list of S object. So the return type of SOSL query is list of S object. Is it clear? Everyone. Please repeat for Apex classes. Apex classes, I think you should ignore Apex classes for a while. So Apex classes is again, Apex classes again another internal object which Salesforce has got to store the information about the different Apex classes. You're never gonna get this Apex class as a result of SSL query inside your Apex until unless you write it down after the returning keyword. So just ignore this Apex classes for a while if you can. Just understand this one only. Okay, perfect. Is it clear to everyone? Right? So what is the return type of SSL query? List of S object, right? Okay, let's go back. So over here, whatever query we are writing down, the return type is list of S object. Now, we cannot write down it without returning, without specifying the object. So we'll write down another SSL query, which is find Volkswagen returning account, comma, contact. We're going to store it in here. And yeah, that's it. Clear? Everyone? Okay. Over here, find Volkswagen returning account, name, comma, number of employees. This is with specified fields. Contact, name, comma, phone. That's what it is. All right?